Spacewalkers resume battery upgrades aboard the space station, a post-flight visit from a couple of recently returned space station astronauts, and a key piece of SLS hardware moves closer to a critical test series. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. On January 15th, our Jessica Meir and Christina Cook ventured outside the International Space Station for a spacewalk, the first of two they will conduct this month, to complete the battery upgrades started on the station last year. Meir and Cook are scheduled to be back outside the station on January 20th. Then, if all goes as planned, on January 25th, our Andrew Morgan and Luca Parmitano of ESA are expected to conduct the station's third spacewalk this month. On that outing, the pair will finish the installation of the Alpha Magnetic Spectrometer's new cooling equipment that began late last year. Former space station crew members Anne McLean and Nick Haig were in the Washington, D.C. area for several post-flight appearances, including a short presentation for employees at NASA headquarters. The pair also appeared on a segment of the Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum's What's New in Aerospace. McLean and Haig spent more than 6 months in space and conducted a combined 5 spacewalks. The first Space Launch System rocket core stage for our Artemis program arrived at our Stennis Space Center in Mississippi on January 12th aboard the agency's Pegasus barge. Engineers there will use the center's B-2 test stand to conduct a series of integrated tests with the core stage, known as the Green Run Test Series, to verify that it is ready for launch ahead of our uncrewed Artemis 1 mission around the moon and back. We released new imagery of a test at our Glenn Research Center with Viper, the mobile lunar robot being developed to search for water ice at the moon's south pole. The golf cart-sized rover will be delivered to the moon through our Commercial Lunar Payload Services Initiative before we land the first woman and next man on the moon in 2024. On January 15th, NASA and the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration provided the annual release of global temperature data. Independent analyses by both agencies found that Earth's global surface temperatures in 2019 ranked second warmest only to those of 2016 and continued the planet's long-term warming trend. The past 5 years have been the warmest years on record since modern record-keeping began in 1880. NASA uses the unique vantage point of space to observe Earth and to better understand the processes that affect our home planet. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.